curry.
It has to be a baby laugh.
A wasp.
Don't know. Sewage.
My little girl and shouts mum.
Probably when the dog's just done a fresh one.
Oh, celery.
Like velvets and satins and silks and stuff.
Fresh tomatoes.
Over 360,000 people in the UK are registered blind or visually impaired.
Two weeks after Christmas, he told me that they couldn't save the sight of the right eye. It's completely blind. I can see a little bit, but it's slightly hazy. But I can see you in the room and all of that, and the dogs. But I'm not allowed out by myself yet for the traffic.
The time is 11:45 a.m.
Well, I can't read or write at all, really. But I do have audio books from the library. I'm on their list of the registered blind. So there's no charge. And my husband gets 4 or 5 audio books for me. Some are discs and some are a little playway. And they're very, very useful. I was amazed at the amount of help I got. There are 7 or 8 organisations on the Wirral that all see to the blind, and I was given every possible help. When you lose one sight, one sense, the others, of course, have to compensate. Touch is the most usual one. I can handle something and find out what it is, even if I can't see the detail very much.
Guide Dogs is a charity, so it's not funded through the government, you know, so all of our money comes from donations, and a lot of the money that we raise comes from legacies, so you know, people leaving us money in their wills. So yeah, the various sort of fundraising things that we do to raise the money, and it actually costs £49,000 per guide dog for the life of the dog, because Guide Dogs also pays for all of the food and the vet bills for the guide dog owner. So that they don't actually have to pay anything out. It only costs the guide dog owner 50 pence to become the legal owner of the dog. There are lots of people out there that don't realise that they're eligible to have a guide dog. A lot of people think that they have to be totally blind in order to qualify to have a guide dog, but in fact most people that are guide dog owners do have some vision. And in fact, out of people that are registered blind, there's only 3% of those people who actually see nothing at all. So most guide dog owners will have a little bit of vision. So that's one of the sort of misconceptions about guide dog ownership. We breed all our own dogs. We have over 1,200 dogs that are bred in the centre near Leamington Spa every year. And when the dogs are 6 weeks old, they go and live with a volunteer puppy walker. And that person looks after the dog until they're 12 months old. And they do sort of socialising, they take them on buses, trains. You might have seen them, they wear a little blue coat and it says guide dog puppy in training. And then when the dog's 12 months old, they come back to guide dogs and then they start doing basic training. And that involves basically following a building line and stopping all of the curbs. Then when the dog is 14 to 16 months old, they go on to advanced training. And that's when we teach them to think about having a person, sort of guiding a person as well. And they have themselves and the person inside a bubble. And then anything that comes into the bubble, like trees that might be overhanging or wheelie bins on a pavement, the dog will guide the person around that. So it's about teaching them how to do that.